declaration of acceptance of office. I, Geoffrey Christopher John Watt, having been elected to the office of Mayor of the Metropolitan Borough of Wirral, declare that I take the office upon myself and will duly and faithfully fulfil the duties of it according to the best of my judgment and ability. I undertake to observe the code of conduct which is expected of members of the Metropolitan Borough of Wirral. Would members and guests please remain standing while my chaplain, Reverend Professor David Chester, says prayers.
Just a moment of stillness before we pray together. A prayer for the Borough Council of Wirral. We lift our hearts, O Lord, in intercession for those who carry civic political responsibility. Grant that putting aside all merely selfish ambition, they may seek to be instruments of your will and carry out your purpose for the welfare of your people, and may they both seek and see your glory in happier human lives through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And a prayer for Geoffrey as he begins his year of office. Thank you, Lord, that in every age you raise up worthy people with experience and commitment to care for the local community. Please bless Geoffrey in his term of office as Mayor of this borough and for our, granting the good health and stamina he needs to fulfil his responsibilities. By your Holy Spirit, granting the gifts of wisdom, prudence and courage in the decisions he will have to take. By your grace, bring all his good work to fruition. We ask this through Jesus Christ, the Lord bless you and watch over you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look kindly on you and give you his peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be with you now and forever. Amen.
Thank you, David. Please be seated. Granddaughter's first question was, do you want to be mayor? Following weeks of campaigning and a declaration made in the early hours after two recounts that I had been elected with a majority of just 20 votes, frankly, becoming mayor was the last thing on my mind. I just wanted to face the challenges of learning how to be an effective ward councillor representing my residents. And so it continued. Mayors came and mayors went. Some were kind enough to say that it could be me one day. I did not believe them and never saw myself in the role. So how did I get here? Well, it turns out that one of my father's distant relations, James Drinkwater, was mayor of Liverpool in 1810. And one of his relations, Sir George Drinkwater, was also mayor in 1830 and was present at the opening of the Liverpool to Manchester Railway. Now, railway buffs will recall that this was when the Liverpool MP, William Huskisson, alighted from the train during a watering stop at Parkside Station in Newbury Willows and was struck by Stevenson's rocket, no less, which was proceeding along the other track. His leg was crushed, and despite being conveyed by the train to Hackney's, accompanied by the said mayor, the unfortunate MP expired. It was around that time one side of my father's family came to Hoylake, which was before the town even got that name, and the other side came in the 1890s. My mother's family came to West Kirby in 1916 and moved to Hoylake in 1921. My parents married after my father's demobilisation, and a few years later moved to Grange, the township whose existence this council refuses to acknowledge, a month before I was born. I count myself fortunate to have spent my childhood on and around the hill, and to have begun my schooling at Cumberby, a family-run school which existed in West Kirby from the late 40s to the early 60s. By the time I started, it had moved to a fine red brick house called The Grange, which you see above the bend as you drive up the hill from the station. Now, good teachers are important, as all we parents and school governors know. And I'm so pleased that my first teacher, Miss Hazelhurst, as was, is here with us this evening. Fast forward to the early 70s, and I was offered a job at a family firm of auctioneers, surveyors, valuers and estate agents opposite Hampton Square Station. The senior partner was Maurice Bacon, Birkenhead Borough Council, who was soon involved in the elections for the shadow authority that would become Wirral Borough Council in 1974. Frequent visitors to the office around that time would include future mayors Harry Devereux and Michael Moore. Councillor Maurice Baker would later become Chief Whip and Chair of Leisure Services. He was a quietly spoken gentleman, and bearing a resemblance to the actor playing the proprietor of the Grace Brothers in Are You Being Served? I think it was the Wirral Globe that began calling him Young Mr. Grace. There, I believe, was a councillor who really should have worn this chain. As Councillor Lewis mentioned, my first attempt at becoming Wirral councillor was in Upton Ward in 1986. At the time, my father asked, "What do you want to do that for?" I think my mother was quietly proud. Anyway, I am delighted that my ward chairman from that time, as mentioned by Councillor Lewis, Cat Bossons, is here this evening, together with Irene Whitehurst, who was then our Constituency Association Chair. It was Irene's husband, Councillor Bill Whitehurst, who designed the new Hoylake Urban District Council coat of arms that I have worn on the Hoylake chair throughout my year as Deputy Mayor. When eventually I did get elected for Royden Ward, it was with the encouragement of Councillor Derek Robertson and his lovely wife Dorothy, who continued to offer support despite Derek's and later her own deteriorating health. Now for some words of thanks. I wish to thank the President and members of Cordy Rugby Club for the pleasure they give to their supporters as they compete in National League One, the third tier of English rugby. Their grounds and pitches are maintained by volunteers known affectionately as the Last of the Summer Wine, some of whom are here this evening, including one gentleman who still marks out the pitches despite playing fly half for the first team before I was born. Well done, Steve. And while we're talking sport, as has already been mentioned, may I add my congratulations to Mark and Nicola Palios and Tranmere Rovers on their return to the Football League. Our son was at Wembley to see the 10-man triumph. My thanks to the officers and young people from Cork holding Grange Grammar School Combined Cadet Force, providing the Guard of Honour this evening, including my newly appointed Mayor's Cadet, Cadet Sergeant James Scott Myers from their RAF section, attending his first engagement. I would also thank my friends from the Wirral Symphony Orchestra, who have provided the string quartet and been prepared just to be in the background and to be talked over this evening. I hope you agree that they've contributed to the atmosphere of this occasion. I've certainly enjoyed their music.